drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself, far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread, la, a note to follow, so, tea, a drink with jam and bread, that will bring us back to when you know the notes to sing, you can sing most anything. A doe, a deer, a female deer, hooray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself, a long, long way to run.
doubt once again. There's Ermengarde, Reverend Mother.
There's no doubt about Ermengarde.
The religious life is no place for the pious.
You mean the pretentiously pious, Sister Bertha?
Of course, Reverend.
There's Christina and Maria.
Well, after last night, I don't think there can be any doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Bertha.
Little girl, I used to go up the mountain, climb a tree, look into the abbey, into the garden. I'd see the sisters at work, and I'd hear them sing on their way to the Vespers. Many nights I'd go back up the mountain, singing all the way. And that brings up another transgression. I was singing yesterday, and I was singing without your permission.
Maria, it's only here in the abbey that we have the rule about singing.
Oh, but that's the hardest rule of all for me, Mother.
Sister Margaret is always reminding me, but too late. It's after I've already started singing.
And the day you were singing, in the garden, at the top of your voice.
Oh, but Mother, it's just that kind of a song.
I came to the window, and when you saw me, you stopped.
Yes, that's been on my mind ever since it happened.
That's been on my mind, too. I wish you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song when I was a girl. Please, would you sing to remind me of the words?
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied on the string. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream colored ponies and crisp apple strudel, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, walkies that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and my lashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bear stings, when I feel it sad, I simply remember my favorite things. Whiskers on kittens, dry copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied on the strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, walkies that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
We're both singing at the top of our voices.
You're right. It's that kind of a song.
It always makes me feel better.
Reverend Mother, where did you learn that song?
I was brought up on those mountains myself. Maria, in spite of what you saw over the abbey wall, you weren't prepared for the way they lived, were you?
Oh, no, Mother, but I pray and I try.
Tell me, Maria, what is the most important lesson you've learned here?
To learn what is the will of God and to do it.
Even if it is hard to accept?
Oh, even then.
Maria, the dress you wore when you came to us, is it still in the roaming room?
Oh, no, Mother. I'm sure that was given to the poor. Sister Margareta always says that... Reverend Mother, why do you ask?
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Leave? Leave here? Oh, no, Mother, please.
No, for a while only, Maria.
No, Mother, this is what I want. This is my life.
But are you ready for it? Perhaps we go out into the world again for a time. You can return to us knowing what we expect of you. And that we do expect it.
I know what you expect and I'll do it, Maria!
If it's the will of God,
where am I to go?
There's a family. A family of seven children. Oh, you like children, Maria. You're very good with them. governess until September.
Until September?
Captain von Trapp expects you late this afternoon.
He's a fine man.
And a brave one. He was once awarded the Maria Theresa Medal from the Emperor. It was for heroism in the Adriatic.
Captain in the Navy, oh mother, he'll be very strict.
You're not being sent to his battleship. Come with John. God bless you, Maria.
Reverend Mother, do I have your permission to sing?
Yes, my daughter.
Thank you. You are Fräulein...
Maria. Maria Reiner.
Now, Maria, as your duties here, I... Would you mind stepping over there? Before you meet the children, you will put on another dress.
But I haven't another dress. When we enter the Abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
The poor didn't want this one.
This is what you'd call a worldly dress?
It belonged to our last postulant. I would have made myself another dress, but I wasn't given any time. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you're given some material today if possible. Now, you'll be in charge of my children. There are 7 of them. You'll find out how far they've gone in their studies and carry on from there. Each morning is spent in the classroom. Each afternoon, they march. You will see that at all times, they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule of this house is discipline.
Yes, sir!
Children, this is your new governess, Fräulein Maria. When I sound your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fräulein, will listen and learn their signals so that you can call them when you want them.
Lisa.
Frieder.
Luisa.
Collect.
Martha. Brigitte. Gretel.
Now, Fräulein, let's see how well you listen.
I couldn't whistle to them. Reverend Captain, what I mean is, I'll be with them all the time.
Not on all occasions. This is a large house and a large estate. They've been taught only to come when they hear no signals. Now, when I'm on you, this is what you'll hear.
You won't have to trouble, sir, because I couldn't answer to a whistle.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
This is Franz, my orderly, the new governess, Fräulein Maria.
Yes, sir?
This is the executive officer, Frau Schmidt, the housekeeper. Fräulein Maria, please be sure that her room is ready.
Yes, sir.
Well, Fräulein, I leave the children to you. You are in command.
Excuse me, sir, but I'm not exactly sure how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return this whistle. Captain, I won't be needing it. Captain. Well, now that it's just us, would you please tell me your names again? Oh, and say how old you are, too. Now you're...
I'm Liesl. I'm 16 years old, and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me. We'll just be friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14, and I'm a boy.
Boy? Why, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigitte.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Luisa.
I'm Brigitte. She's Luisa, and she's 13 years old, and you're smart. I'm 7, and I think you're just the ugliest one That's my sage to be. 11. Almost.
I'm Marta, and I'm going to be 9 on Tuesday, and I'd like a pink pad sock.
Pink's my favorite color, too. And you must be Gretel. Listen, I'm going to tell you something. I've never been a governess before. How do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do is tell Father to mind his own business.
Louisa, don't!
I like her.
What's in here?
Oh, that's my guitar.
What did you bring this for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
You don't sing? Of course you sing. Everybody sings. What songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
Well, I guess I know where to start then. I'm going to teach you all how to sing.
Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start.
When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi. The first three notes just happen to be.
I'll make it easier for you.
Joe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow song. Tea, a drink of jam and bread.
Once we have these notes in our heads, we can sing a million different tunes.
How?
By mixing them up. Listen.
So do ba fa mi do re.
Now you try it.
So do la fa mi do re. So do the ti.
Yes. Well,
Good night, Ralph.
Lisa.
Yes?
You know, you don't have to say goodnight just because your father's home.
How did you know my father's home?
Oh, I have a way of knowing things.
You're wonderful.
No, I'm not. Really.
Oh, yes, you are. I mean, how did you know 2 days ago that you'd be here at just this time tonight with a telegram from Franz?
Every year on his birthday, he gets a telegram from his sister.
You see, you are wonderful.
Can I come again tomorrow night?
Ralph, you can't be sure you're going to have another telegram to deliver here tomorrow night.
I could come here by mistake with a telegram for Colonel Snyder. He's here from Berlin. He's staying with the Gauleiter, but no one's supposed to know he's here. Don't you tell your father.
Why not?
Well, your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
I know, but some people think we ought to be German. They're getting pretty mad at those who don't think so. They're getting ready to, well, let's just hope your father doesn't get into any trouble.
Don't you worry about father. He was decorated for his bravery.
I know, I don't worry about your father. The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you, Lisa?
16. What's wrong with that?
Your life, little girl, is an empty page that captain ordered for you for a new dress.
Oh, how nice of him. Even before it's made, it's the prettiest dress I've ever had.
I hope the captain likes it. Because I was going to ask him for more material.
More material?
Oh, no, no, not for me. For the children, for play clothes.
The Von Trapp children never play.
The captain doesn't like them to get dirty. But they're children. They have to roll the grass, climb trees, think of all the rocks in the cave.
The captain says the best exercise is marching. And the children will continue to march. I hope you find your room comfortable.
Yes, thank you.
There will be new curtains to match the bedspread. They'll be hung tomorrow.
Why? These curtains are very good.
There will be new curtains.
Will the captain be away long?
Well, he has to come home every time he has to hire a new governess. Sometimes I think the children get rid of their governesses just so he'll come home to them.
Well, he must want to see them too.
Ever since his wife died, they remind him too much of her. You can put that away. You won't be needing it here.
Why not?
The captain doesn't allow music in his house.
He won't allow music.
He used to love music. There were wonderful evenings here. His wife would sing and he would play the violin or the guitar, but he shut that all out of his life.
Huh. So that's why he's the way he is.
Yes, well, it will work out. The captain may be remarried before the summer's over.
That would change everything. They would have a mother again, the children.
Yes, wouldn't it be nice? Well, I think it's going to rain. You might want to close your window.
Thank you.
Have a good evening.
Dear God, I know now that you have sent me here on a mission. I must teach these children to love their new mother and prepare them to win her love so that she will never want them to leave her in my sight. And I pray that this will become a happy family. God bless the captain. God bless Liesl, Friedrich, Louisa, Brigida, Marta, and little Gretel. Oh, I forgot the other boy. What's his name?
Well, God bless what's his name.
God bless Reverend Mother, and God bless Sister Margareta, and everybody at Blockburger Abbey. And now, dear God, about Liesl. Help her to know that I am her friend.
Tell me what she can offer. Are you going to tell me?
Help me to be understanding so that I may lead her in my footsteps. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
I was out taking a walk, and they locked the doors earlier than usual, and I didn't want to wake everybody up. So when I saw your window open, you're not going to tell me, are you?
Liesl, did you climb the trellis to get up here?
Why, yes. How do you think you always got into the governess's room to play tricks on her? Louisa is climbing with a toad in her hand.
Liesl, were you out walking all by yourself? You know, if we wash that dress out tonight, nobody would notice it tomorrow. Then all of this could be just between you and me. Come here. Put these on. Go let your dress soak in the bathtub. And then you can come here. You can come here. Sit at the edge of my bed and we'll have a little chat.
I told you that I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh, it's you, Gretel. Are you afraid?
Boys are brave.
so you went.
Was this your idea, Friedrich?
Oh no, it was Kurt's.
That's the one that I left out. Kurt. God bless Kurt.
I wish you wouldn't answer so loud.
Well, maybe if we sing loudly enough, we won't hear it.
Exciting. I've never been called exciting before.
I'm beginning to understand you better now that I see you here. You know, you're a little like these mountains, except that you're always moving. How is it that you could stand to be away from here as much as you are?
Maybe I've been searching for a reason to come back to stay.
Georg, I'd like it here very much.
Max can't still be on the telephone. I know he's desperate for getting singers for the Cold Spring Festival, but you like it here?
Well, we'd have to spend some time in Vienna. I have Heinrich's estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is, and I'm president.
You're president of a corporation?
After all, I managed Heinrich's affairs for years before he died.
I can't imagine you sitting behind a desk.
Well, of course, I wear a suit and smoke a big fat cigar.
Excuse me, Captain. I'd rather like this coffee now.
While he's telephoning?
It's just finished.
Sorry I took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the festival? The finest choral group in Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in all of Europe. And the best soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. Right now, all I've got is a basso who isn't even profundo.
Max, you always come up with a good festival concert.
And why? Because my motto is, never start looking up for the people you wind up getting. So I've been calling Stockholm, Rome, London, Paris.
On Georg's telephone?
How else can I afford it? Why am I up here?
I hoped it was because you liked me.
Of course I like you. You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max.
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official, Georg, does this place have a cathedral around here?
That's our abbey, Nottenberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good, good. In the next few days, I have to visit all these small towns. Listen to Sangerbans, choirs, quartets.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Of course. It was in a town just about that size, Watson, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. They won the festival in 1930, toured all over the world, became famous.
Oh, yes. Whatever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Well, isn't that old dilapidated castle down there, Rumpelstiltskin?
Baron Elberfeld, the oldest family in the valley.
Georg, I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all of your friends. While I'm here, why don't you hold a party for me? Nothing much, just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. Today it's difficult to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
This isn't a good time to be making enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
Well, it couldn't have been an intentional slight. They haven't met me yet.
Excuse me, I'll try and find them.
So, Elsa, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry her?
Yes, but he hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
You don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's money.
Money?
Yes, simple. He's rich, and you're rich. And all the famous love affairs of lovers have to struggle. Gertrude's webs, there's lovers, starve and snuggle. They're famous for misfortune, which they seem to have no fear of. While lovers who are very true, very seldom hear of.
Find them anywhere.
No, little shack, do you share with me? We do not flee from the mortgagee. Nary a care in the world have we. How can love survive? You're fond of bonds and you own a lot. I have a plane and a diesel yacht.
Plenty of nothing you haven't got.
How
It's a good thing you haven't any character, because if you had, I'm convinced I'd hate you.
You can't hate me. I'm too lovable.
Detweiler, there's a call from you. It's from...
I'll take it.
What's that? children? Singing?
I wanted them to sing for Frau Schrader when they met her.
Georg, you must hear!
Started.
have German blood, haven't you?
I am not a German, I am an Austrian.
There's going to be an Anschluss, I warn you, and everyone like you, and that goes for our... It's much more comfortable out on the terrace. Baron Elberfeld, it's good to have you and the Baroness Elberfeld here again.
Frau Schrader's charming, Georg.
I hope she isn't ill. Oh, no, just a headache. I'm actually going up to her now. We'll meet you on the terrace.
Father, I don't think these people are having a very good time.
Half the people I invited aren't speaking to the other half.
Well, maybe they're having a good time not speaking to each other.
Sir, Frau Schrader asked me to tell you that she'll be joining you for a minute.
Thank you. You might ask if she would like this glass of brandy.
Yes, sir. I haven't danced since I was a very little girl.
Oh, come on, you remember the Lendler. Please show me.
Yes,
but you said left hand behind the back. What were you talking about?
Yes, but first the boy and the girl meet.
Yes.
And then they go for a little stroll. Frau Schrader.
I like
mother.
Oh, Fräulein, father can never marry her, why he couldn't.
And why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Brigida, that's...
You must know that.
It's just the kind of thing.
Remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing that Edelweiss song the parlor taught us? After we finished singing, you laughed at him for forgetting the words. He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you.
Brigida.
And the way he speaks to you, the way his voice sounds.
No, Brigida, no.
And the way you looked at him just now when you're dancing. You were in love with him.
Brigida. No. No, Brigida. It's wrong. I couldn't possibly be.
Yes, you're in love with him.
One more dance, Gretel, and then to bed. Oh, Fräulein Maria, there's been a change of plans. You're not having dinner with the children tonight. You're having dinner with us. But don't say anything, it's all been arranged. You better go change. And Maria, wear the dress you wore the other night. It was beautiful, soft and white. Wish to say goodnight to you.
A singing group of seven children, one family.
Now we have influence. We must talk to him. Elsa, this is important, Natasha. And it wouldn't do me any harm.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If
I did. I didn't know that I did. But I'm a mother. I do know this. I'm ready, at this very moment, to take the vows of poverty, obedience, and chastity. Maria, the love between a man and a woman is holy too. When we first talked together, you told me you remembered your mother and father before they died. Do you remember, were they happy? Oh yes, mother, they were very happy. Maria, you were born of their happiness, of their love. And my child, you have a great capacity to love. What you must find out is, how does God want you to spend that love? But I pledged my life to God. But if you love this man, it doesn't mean you love God any less. You must find out. You must go back. Reverend Mother, please don't ask me to go back. Maria, these walls are not made to shut out problems. You have to face them. You have to find the life you were born to live. How do I find it? You look for it.